So basically you can start your training with a smartphone in your personal life to train like an astronaut. So all the physical, knowledge-based aspects, social, teamwork aspects, and then we select the best ones there into an on-site training, which we will also film and people can follow that too. And it's all done with the real NASA astronaut trainers. And the best candidate per each year we will send to space. First into suborbital, then to the orbital, International Space Station, Moon and beyond later. Well, it depends on the mission. So basically, the mobile phase lasts like 3 months or so. And then after that, it's about 3 months what is ultimately that who will be chosen as the best candidate. But depending on the mission, so if you go to suborbital, that would be enough. But if you go to the International Space Station, it means that you go into specific training for at least a year more. Actually, that is a common myth. So basically, you don't need to be super fit, super smart, but you need to have a basic health. You need to have like logical problem-solving skills, creative problem-solving skills, learning new things and applying them, and above all, teamwork. So not just getting along with different cultures, but actually working with them, because in space your life might depend on that. Suborbital, not so much, but to the orbit. So it'll price point like first, depending who, what provider we use, might be hundreds of thousands, and then ultimately to the orbit, we are talking about millions, basically. I think you know the answer, yes. So whole space industry and all people in the industry and around that know that, and it's just a matter of time. Now the price points are crashing down, and it's going to happen much, much faster than anyone can dream of. So taking like a transatlantic flight soon to the orbit, later in the moon, taking holidays or go to live there, that is the future.